I spoke mainly about unity, the need for unity. We all need to stand strong, stand firm for Kashmiris who have no possibility to even talk right now. They are locked, basically locked in their houses. It's like a prison, and they have not been able to communicate for 3 weeks. And we need to speak up for them, and we need to stand united in that. And also, we need to call for the right this time, the right to self-determination.
And what do you like to add about, what do you think about India is doing right now in Kashmir, how we can stop it or how we can go around and tell people about the situation, how it can help us, and what do you think?
I think I have seen an uprising in voices for Kashmir. It's been massive on social media. We have seen politicians also actually condemning India, which hasn't happened before. There are a lot of demonstrations, big, massive demonstrations in London, for example. And I think that we need to continue. This is like a little watershed moment where we start to get maybe a little bit tired. It's 3 weeks and it's still going on. But here we really need to step up and continue, because if we are tired, I can assure you that the Kashmiri people are much, much more tired. They have had this fear that this would happen for years, and lived with that fear, and also lived with all the human rights violations that India has been committing in the region. So we owe it to them to continue talking about the human rights abuses, to talk about the previous crimes, to talk about what is going on right now, all the rights that are taken away from Kashmiris.